Hey folks, Bryan Martin coming at you from the Chrome Shop Mafia, and once again with Glenn English.
Morning.
And today we have got a topic that we've been wanting to do for a while, but it's rather complex, a lot of different variations. We're going to show you, to the best of our ability, how to identify what fifth wheel you've got on your truck. In the event you need to order bushings, you need to order a top plate, you need to order an air cylinder, we're going to help you be able to discern at a glance, hopefully, what fifth wheel your truck's equipped with.
And the brackets that mount it, air cylinders, so on, anything to rebuild the fifth wheel.
Now when it comes to fifth wheel, kind of the 350 Chevy of fifth wheels is going to be the Holland product line. Seemed like every truck since the 60s, 70s, 80s, the far majority had a Holland.
Yes, sir.
And then some of them, a good percentage of them, would have a Fontaine.
Yeah.
But today, as of the last decade or so, Jost, J-O-S-T, Jost fifth wheels are coming on relatively strong. We're going to show you how to identify if they're inboard or outboard, standard profile, low profile, how to measure your slide bracket, things like that. So Glenn, what do you say? What are we going to start with?
For starters, let's just go look for an old style Holland and see what we can come up with.
Good idea. What we've got here is your traditional shaped Holland fifth wheel. There again, the one they've been using for decades. It's kind of a cast steel product, isn't it?
Correct.
Cast iron. And it's got real traditional teeth here, as you can see, that there again, they've been using for decades. So I'm going to call this the old style Holland. Some other indicators besides the standard looking teeth is the slide bracket, which is the part here that your fifth wheel is attached to. The slide bracket, the left and right slide bracket towers are actually welded together. So yes. Your slide bracket is one piece, rather than the late model, which is two-piece.
Yep. And then another easy way to tell them apart is, I believe most of the old style, the pin slides in right here, and then it has a roll pin on the inside that locks it in place, where the new style has a bolt on the outside.
Yeah, gotcha. This one here is a little bit unique. It's a low profile, so the fifth wheel is down lower, which caused Holland to put the cylinder out front. So this is a low profile. Of course, you can get them in a standard height and then an extra tall height. This one here, you can see, by the way, the angle irons mount it to the frame. They would call this an inboard mount. Old style Holland, low profile slide bracket, inboard mount. Left-hand release. Of course, you can get just about any of these fifth wheels, I suppose, in a left-hand release or a right-hand release.
Which I believe the left-hand's more common on the driver's
side. Much more common. Now, we showed you what a low profile old style Holland fifth wheel looked like. Right here is kind of your standard profile. So notice, instead of the cylinder being out front, the air cylinder is actually mounted up underneath the fifth wheel plate. So this is an old style standard slide bracket. Okay, let's go look now for a Holland new style.
Here we have the new style Holland top plate ILS series. This is a left hand release, standard mount. The air cylinder is up underneath instead of out in front like a low pro. And then you can see that the bolts on the outside here that locks the pin in, instead of having the roll pin underneath like the old style. This slider right here is an outboard mount, and you can see the new style teeth here instead of the old style.
When Holland developed the ILS series fifth wheels, the driving force was to make a lighter weight fifth wheel assembly. So a quick visual reference is the new style teeth. It looks much different than what we've had for the last 30 or 40 years. So that's a quick identifier. The other thing is the slide brackets, the tower that your fifth wheel rests on, they're two-piece, a left and a right. So, A, they're lighter weight, they're actually lower cost and easier to change. So that's another identifier of the ILS Holland series. As well as you can see, traditionally, they're gonna have a trimmed down top plate to aid in weight savings as well.
Here's another Holland new style top plate, the ILS system, but this has got the more traditional larger top plate on it, and has the inboard mounted track on it. Cylinder still underneath for a standard profile.
What do you say we go seek out a Fontaine now?
Sounds like a plan.
Here we've got a traditional Fontaine. Once again, a very popular fifth wheel. Most of them, I find, my opinion, were this stamped steel top plate. They did offer a cast iron or a cast steel in many cases, but this one was a little more popular. This one here, of course, you can see your slide bracket. Your base plate, which this is an outboard mount again. This one's a low profile, cylinder's out front. You can get the slide brackets in various heights, you know, depending whether you're pulling a reefer or an end dump or a grain trailer, anything like that can be changed. This one's a left-hand pull. Pretty traditional on all their apparatus. The appearance of the slide brackets, the locking pins, the locking teeth have looked the same for a lot of decades, haven't they, Glenn?
Oh, yeah. But this one's kind of like the late-style Holland. It's got the easy removal on the pins. You just drop it out from the outside, pull the pin, and you can change it out or change parts that you need to change. So pretty easy to work on.
Most all fifth wheels, regardless of what brand we're talking about, if this plate becomes worn, the jaws, the locking mechanisms are worn, you can order a rebuild kit and rebuild it. You can get a new or reman top plate assembly. You can buy slide brackets, you can buy bushings, pins, air cylinders, everything serviceable from all three manufacturers we're talking about today.
Yes, sir.
Looks like the only one missing is a Jost. Let's go see if we can find one.
Sounds good.
We were out walking Jost, looking around, and we found this Jost. Get it, Jess Jost? Hey, we were Jost looking around and we found this Jost fifth wheel, which worked out pretty good.
Yeah.
Jost has really made a name for themselves the last many years. They have got their own proprietary fifth wheel, which I think you can order on a new truck, or you
right.
can certainly buy the aftermarket Jost complete assembly and put on your truck. But a pretty cool feature is Jost came out with a replacement top plate that they manufacture that you can buy and put on your Holland fifth wheel assembly. And then they've got a different aftermarket Jost top plate that you can buy and put on your Fontaine fifth wheel assembly. Pretty unique look to a Jost fifth wheel. It looks like they've got a big heavy cast steel top plate. This one's a left-hand pull. Easily identifiable here on the pin lock tab. It's got their name in it.
This one here is a stationary fifth wheel. Doesn't have no air slide on it. You can get them in different heights. It is somewhat adjustable. It has holes here, you can unbolt it and move it, but not as easy as the air slide by any means. And this one's on an outboard mount.
On all these fifth wheels we've showed you today, something to keep in mind, these things are gonna last 750,000, million miles a lot of times if they're properly greased and maintained with almost no maintenance. It's very seldom somebody is gonna come into a store like ours and say, I need a complete fifth wheel assembly from the frame up.
Right.
It does happen, but it's rare. Usually we're selling replacement top plates because they're worn out beyond rebuilding. A lot of pins and bushings
right.
from just wear and tear as the truck starts and stops. Air cylinders to unlock the slide brackets. What else am I missing there?
The hoses, coupler kits, inside rebuild kits. Mm-hmm. And we sell some sliders, very popular when you're trying to change fenders or add fenders and you need to change the height.
Mm-hmm. Slide brackets come in a host of different heights and they're all measured somewhat uniquely. They usually measure from the top of the frame rail to the top of your slide bracket, which equals pretty much the top of the fifth wheel. So if you're saying it's 6 inch there, 9 inch, 4.5 inch, that's going to be the height of your slide bracket. As Glenn said, a lot of people do need to change the slide brackets because they bought a used truck that had been pulling a reefer that was really low. Now they're pulling a hopper bottom or an end dump. They want to raise it up, get some clearance for their full fenders. All right, I know we hit you with a lot of info there in a short time, but hopefully that'll help you identify whether you've got a Holland old style, Holland new style, Fontaine, or a Jost fifth wheel on your truck, and when you go up to that parts counter, you'll know what to ask for. If you like what you've seen here today, go ahead and subscribe. We're gonna be doing this every couple of weeks and bringing you more totally useless information that you can choose to do with what you wish. See you next time.